Alright everyone, today we're messing around with our little blue buggy here. And zoom out any new. Anyway. There you go, that's what she looks like. I'll figure out how to put a picture in there. I'll show you what it looked like when I started with it. Not quite finished, but got a lot done to this thing. I've had it for maybe a year, year and a half or so. Lately I've just been doing a little bit of welding. Have a bunch of holes down in here. But the point of today is I want to talk to you about engine in play. Or crankshaft in play on a Volkswagen. The death of many good motors, and most people just don't know that it's a factor. See if I can get y'all down in here. A little bit lower. Can y'all see the pool? Endplay, when you go look at your little Volkswagen that runs, everybody says just pull back and forth on this, you'll be able to feel it. That's never been the case for me. I've never been able to feel it. And here's the scarier part. This engine runs pretty good. It runs so good I plan on running it as is. Pretty good. Well, I'll pull the engine out and I'll be able to show you what I'm talking about in crankshaft in play failures and disasters. Alright, the engine was pulled out. I'm gonna get in here and look at this throw spare in. The camera's been captured that very well. See it moving? It is toast. Best thing to do here is either buy you a new case or find you a good used one. Those good use cases are getting hard to find. So, that's just something to look out for. Looking at your little used Beetle, or whatever it is, maybe a Volkswagen. That's, this is usually what I run into. They almost always need an engine. Like I say, in this case, this one's not rebuilt, so it's a major stumbling block. Well, for me, I have other cases. Some of them's already been machined. We'll go ahead and check this one on our other engine. One that came out of our 66 liter pay. chose to call her Patty because she's kind of like a cat baby coming out of the pasture. Flywheel lock. I'll pull the bolts out. Out of the flywheel. It's a little bit pitted, kind of grooved up. This is an original style. I've not found any replacement like that. Left is still pretty good. Flywheel lock out. So I don't need any movement. It's nice and tight. We have busted into our mystery motor. Figure out what size this thing is. The nearest size to that is 85.5. Which is going to be, this was built into a 1600. There. Definitely a 40 horse built to a 1600. Thirty-three and 30 valves. That's going to be the 1300 cc heads. I guess those were still good when they rebuilt it. You need to check stroke. You can. All I'll do is run the cylinder all the way in. Put your caliper on, have it zeroed. And I'll take it stick it down in there. I'll have to put you on the tripod. All right. Stuffed in there. Just turn it all the way back as far as it'll go. At 70 minus 2 is going to put you at 68, so it's a 69 stroke. So basically, we have a 1600cc engine that was built with 1300cc heads. That's about the kind of junk you find coming behind other people. That's okay. Grab this back out. Almost no deck height. You need at least 45 thousandths. I'll get in here and do a little bit of freshening up. But yeah. That we know it's a 1600cc. And it runs good enough for the little buggy. Alright, we have one of these cylinder heads cleaned up here. It came pretty clean. But this engine was built, maybe not recently, but it don't have a ton of miles on it. Anyway, I'm going to dig around the stash and see if I can come up with enough stuff to dual port this so I can run my off-road carburetor. And probably next we'll go ahead and get this prepped up for off-road use, and we'll do that together as well. See y'all then.